Good morning class. Yesterday I show you this picture. And who is the man? Yes, please tell. You know very well. Yeah, you have spoken right. He is Kailash Satyarthi. Kailash Satyarthi is a social activist who worked for the child education, who worked for child welfare. And he received Nobel Peace Prize for the upliftment of the children, for the helping children with Malala Yousafzai. They both got Nobel Peace Prize. And on the prize giving ceremony, he was asked by the Nobel Committee to deliver a lecture, to deliver a speech. But at that time, what he said? That I am not able to give the speech here. I am representing here the sound of silence. He wanted to set our children free. Yes, set our children free. He wanted that the child should be free to grow and develop, to eat, sleep, and see daylight. Free to laugh and cry, free to play and learn, free to go to school, and above all, free to dream, free to think, free to dream the future, what will happen in his future, what he want to be. Means the child should not be thrown into child labor. He should be free to be a child, to enjoy innocence. So it was a lesson, set our children free. So when he was asked to deliver a lecture there on the prize giving ceremony, so he said, because I am representing here the sound of silence, the cry of innocence, and the face of invisibility. The cries of innocence means those people who need help and attention but do not get it. And who are they? They are children. The face of invisibility here means those who have been neglected. There are many children in the world, those who are neglected. Nobody cares for them. They are working day and night. They didn't see even daylight. What is there? And Kailash Satyarthi worked for them. And he wanted that they should be free to lead a life as a child leads. So he wanted to make them free. So it is the chapter Set Our Children Free. He gave many examples. He also told that 20 years ago when he went to foothills of Himalayas, a child, a skinny laborer, he asked him, is the world so poor that it cannot give me a toy and a book instead of forcing me to take a gun or a tool? Means the boy had tool or gun in his hand instead of books, instead of toys. So he was very upset. Another example he gave that a child mother from Colombia, she asked, I have had never a dream. Can my child have one? Means the mother was not allowed to dream anything. Now she wanted, is the child will be able? The child will be allowed? So Kailash Satyarthi was very upset to hear all these questions. So he worked harder and harder for the benefit of children. And to some extent he was succeed. So he gave the lecture. Not the lecture, but he says that I am representing here the sound of silence. So page number 1 and 2 we have read. See this page we have read. And now page 3 also. Here also we read some example. And some examples were there that an 8-year-old girl we rescued from intergeneration forced laborer from stone quarries. She was sitting in my car right after her rescue and she asked me, Why did not you come earlier? Means the girl was rescued and she got very angry. And she asked a question, why I was so late in coming to save her, to protect her. So because she was very innocent, she asked question that as a child she has to do a lot of work, a lot of labor. Why I was so late to save her? Now we are going to start our next speech. It is, we must be bold, we must be ambitious, and we must have the will, we must keep our promise. So Kailash Satyarthini's speech says that a person must be bold, brave, ambitious, and he must have the willpower. And we must keep our promises. Whatever promise we have done, we must fulfill that. Over 50 years ago, on the first day of my school, I met a cobbler boy, my age, sitting outside the gate of my school. Now he is telling another incident. And what was that? Over 50 years ago, means before 50 years, on the first day of my school, it was the first day of his school and he went to school. I met a cobbler boy and my A sitting outside the gate of my school. I asked my teacher, why is he working outside? Why is he not with us in the school? So I asked a question to my teacher. The boy is of the same age, but he is working outside the school with his father and I am sitting in the class and you are teaching me. So what is the reason for that? My teacher had no answer. The teacher was answerless. The teacher was not able to answer. What to answer? One day I gathered the courage to ask the boy's father. He said, sir, I have never thought about it. We are born to work. So one day Kailash Satyarthi gathered the courage and asked his boy's father. He said, sir, I never thought about it. So what is the answer of the boy's father? He asked that they never thought that the child should go to school. They thought that we are born to work. It is our right to work only, not to get any education. His answer made me angry. It still makes me angry. And when I heard this answer, I got very perturbed. I got very angry. And it still makes me angry. As a child, I had a vision for tomorrow. A vision of that cobbler boy sitting with me in my classroom. So I wanted that the boy should sit with me in the class and he must get the education. Now that tomorrow has become today. I am today and you are today. Today is the time for every child to have a right of life. Right to freedom, right to health, right to education, right to safety, right to dignity, right to equality, and right to peace. So he answered many. He asked that it is not tomorrow, that tomorrow we shall do this, tomorrow we shall do that. No, leave tomorrow and come to today. We have to do all the things today for our children, because it is the right of theirs. Today, beyond the darkness, I see the smiling faces of our children in the blinking stars. Today, in every wave of every ocean, I see my children are playing and dancing. Today, in every plant, in every tree and mountain, I see our children growing freely with dignity. So he has a vision, he has a dream, and what he says, beyond the darkness, means keep away from the darkness. He saw the smiling faces of the children in the blinking stars. Today in every wave of the ocean, he can see the children are playing, children are dancing, they are not working. In every plant, in every tree and mountain, I see our children growing freely with dignity. Friends, I want you to see and feel this is today inside you. Means only you can do these things, none other. Friends, I want to see, I want to feel this today inside you. Means I want participation of everyone who are sitting here, not only me. Today I see thousands of Mahatma Gandhis, Martin Luther Kings and Nelson Mandelas calling on us. And let us democratize knowledge, let us universalize justice. So he called all the people who are sitting in the hall that we have to do all this together. One man cannot do anything. We have to unite and we have to work for the children. Together, let us globalize compassion. I call upon you in this room and the people all across the world. I call for a march from exploitation to education. I call for a march from poverty to shattered prosperity. So he wanted that children should not be exploited. They should be given education. They should not live in poverty. They should share prosperity. A march from slavery to liberty. And a march from violence to peace. Means they should be live with peace and harmony, away from violence, away from slavery. Means they should not be thrown into the child labor. They should have right to work. They should have right to enjoy the life. Asto ma sadgamya, tamso ma jyotirgamya, mrityor ma amritam gamya. He spoke these lines. Let us march from ignorance to awakening. Let us march from darkness to light. And let us march from mortality to divinity. Thank you, students. It's all for today. The lesson is finished. I hope you understood it and you must read it. Thank you. Bye.